What's something that some athletes and Russian astronauts have in common? Well, you might have guessed it already. They both use Rhodiola rosea, commonly known as Arctic root or Aaron's rod. And it's been used now for centuries to cope with the cold Siberian climate, as well as the stresses of life, since it is an adaptogen. It is also used to increase physical endurance and resistance to high altitude sickness, which is why astronauts like it. In this video, we will look at what Rhodiola rosea is, how it may have a role in weight loss, the dosing, as well as the side effects and precautions that you need to know of before taking Rhodiola. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as being in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I'd love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider hitting that subscribe button as well. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. Rhodiola rosea is a plant coming from the family of Crassulaceae. They grow naturally in the wild across Scandinavia, Russia, and certain parts of Asia. And the best known Rhodiola rosea is now cultivated also in Europe and North America. And what makes its potential use cases possible is likely due to these constituents in the plant itself, but mostly these guys on the first column here, which are your transcendental alcohol glycoside compounds like your rosarin, rosevan, and rosins. The seligicide and tyrosyl are just as important here as well, which are going to be used to activate the mTOR pathways needed, which are known to bring on those adaptogenic effects. Because it is an adaptogen after all, like ashwagandha and reishi, which we've talked about already on this channel. Except this time, it's seen as an energizing adaptogen and not a calming one. Which, by the way, if you want an actual definition to what an adaptogen is, here's the best one I found. A non-toxic substance or plant extract that is held to increase the body's ability to resist the damaging effects of stress and promote or restore normal physiological functioning. Thanks, Merriam-Webster. When it comes to weight loss, let's be real. There aren't a ton of studies that really look at this, and if there are, they're done on animal studies, particularly this one here on rats, which showed that a combination of citrus aurantium, which is your bitter orange, combined with Rhodiola rosea, showed that after the 10-day treatment, no impact on feeding or body weight in obese animals occurred, but did result in a decrease in visceral fat weight. Interestingly though, when we come to the world of sports nutritional studies, one that I thought was actually quite fascinating was this one here, a double-blind placebo-controlled study where they were actually able to find acute Rhodiola rosea intake can improve endurance exercise capacity in young healthy volunteers. And why is that relevant to weight loss? Because improving endurance and exercise capacity can help increase your resting metabolic rate, which helps you to burn more calories when you're resting, giving you a boost with your weight loss. But what if there was another way? You see, with weight gain and obesity, it's a complex disease state driven by so many different causes that are multifactorial. Just because you read a study on a supplement for weight that looks promising does not mean that there's enough data to start taking it for weight loss. You have to look at the underlying causality of your own individual causes of being overweight and obese in the first place. The only real link that I can see Rhodiola rosea playing for weight loss is if your condition is caused by excess cortisol. And that's really about it. Because we know that psychophysiological response to stress may influence subsequent eating behavior. When our cortisol is high, we overeat, and when we overeat, we cause that weight gain. This is where you can say that the link between adaptogens and weight loss can be made because of its effects on cortisol. Now the question is, does Rhodiola rosea have a way to bring down cortisol levels on its own, bring down our stress so we don't overeat and store more fat? The strongest evidence you might say that it's plausible is this one here. A randomized double-blind placebo-controlled trial looking at Rhodiola rosea in the treatment of individuals suffering from stress-related fatigue concluded that repeated administration of exerts an anti-fatigue effect that increases mental performance, particularly the ability to concentrate and decrease cortisol response to awakening stress in burnout patients with fatigue syndrome. So instead of actually targeting adipose tissue to cause weight loss, it decreases cortisol-induced appetite changes, which may play a role in weight loss if your condition is because of high cortisol. Let's talk about dosing. Some studies suggest that doses as low as 200 milligrams may be effective, but if you're considering it for its adaptogenic uses, then 400 to 600 milligrams should be your daily target. And seeing how it is an energizing adaptogen, it only makes sense to take it in the morning since you don't want all of that energy closer to bedtime. The most common side effects reported from taking rhodiola is an overstimulation or feeling overly energized. This is especially true if you're taking it with other adaptogens. Also, you might experience dizziness and sometimes even a dry mouth or excess saliva when first trying it out. And because this is a supplement, it's super important that you go with a product that is third-party tested USP or NSF and made in a facility that is GMP certified. If I were to go with a brand, now this isn't sponsored, the 500 milligram one by Double Wit seems to match a lot of the criteria that I look for in a supplement. Also, the one by Pure Encapsulations is not bad either if you're already using their product line. And I've left a link to pick them up in the description below, but don't feel like you have to go with these ones exactly. Just know that there have been companies that have been dishonest about rhodiola. In fact, the FDA sends out warning letters to some companies selling what are basically blanket statements calling rhodiola rosea an ideal drug, or statements like it reduces cancer cells. You want to watch out for companies that are in the business of selling you false information, because chances are they want to sell you a perfect story and take your money. Click the subscribe button below if you found any value in this video and share with me your thoughts down below. I would love to hear from you. And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.